What is immunoprecipitation used for, and how do I choose antibodies to immunoprecipitate my protein? I'm Sarah, product scientist at Cell Signaling Technology, and this is CST Tech Tips. Immunoprecipitation, or IP, can be used to enrich your protein of interest prior to analysis. There are many variations of IP, but the basic concept is to bind the target protein with an antibody, which I'll refer to as the IP antibody, and then precipitate the resulting immune complex on beads derivatized with proteins that bind to the antibody. Following IP, proteins can be analyzed by Western blot, mass spectrometry, or other assays. IP can aid detection of your protein if it is expressed at low abundance, or if you're working with a limited sample. Do you already use IP in your experimental workflow, or are you planning your first IP experiments? Let us know in the comments section below this video. And while you're there, give this video a like and share with your colleagues. Okay, let's consider the conditions in IP compared to Western blot and how that affects binding of the IP antibody. In native IP, during and after cell lysis, proteins are kept in their native folded conformation during the IP reaction. Native IP is suitable for antibodies whose epitopes are on the surface of the protein. But some epitopes may be buried into the center of the protein structure, or located in a binding interface that becomes obscured when other proteins are bound to your target protein. An antibody that recognizes one of these epitopes might be able to detect your protein in the denaturing conditions of a Western blot, but unable to bind its epitope and capture the protein in native IP. For these cases, an alternate protocol using reducing conditions to partially denature the protein may be beneficial. Before setting up your IP, check for validation data from the antibody supplier and check whether a native or denaturing IP protocol is recommended for that antibody. The immunoprecipitated complex can be prepared for Western blotting by washing with lysis buffer and then resuspending and boiling in SDS sample buffer. When it comes to choosing what type of beads to use, the choice of protein A versus protein G beads should be based on the host species of the IP antibody. We recommend protein A agarose or magnetic beads for IP with rabbit antibodies, and protein G agarose or magnetic beads with mouse antibodies. Magnetic beads have gained in popularity, and magnetic separation affords a faster protocol without the need for centrifugation. But whichever format you choose, it's always a good idea to incorporate proper controls. Choosing antibodies for downstream Western blot analysis involves other considerations for your experiment. We'll cover this topic, as well as the different types of experimental controls you should use for IP in future tech tip videos. Thanks for watching. If you found this video informative, don't forget to hit the like button and share it with your lab mates and subscribe for more tech tips. And anytime you have a question about an antibody or a protocol, you can get in touch with a CST scientist at cellsignal.com/support. Good luck with your experiments.